when I think about a father, I think about like somebody who is like there for you. I mean, like most people, they think of fathers and they're like, oh, he's supposed to buy this, he's supposed to do this. I mean, like your father can be a bum and still be a good father. I mean, like, he's at least supposed to be there the way that he can. And when I think about my father, I think it's kind of sad. Because my dad, he has a car. He lives on 35th and King Drive. I know his house. He never calls. And then when I call him, he has my phone number, cell phone, and home phone. When I call him, ask why he doesn't call, he says he doesn't want to talk to my mother. So I'm like, so that's going to stop you from talking to me? He's like, yeah. Well, I would say to him that he needs to get balls and stop acting like everything he blames it on somebody. He doesn't come around because he doesn't want to see my mother. He doesn't call because he fell asleep too. He was cooking dinner and he couldn't call, and after he was finished, he fell asleep. He didn't come by because he just got in town and he had to take a shower. Stuff like that, he needs to stop it and just like think about him, because it's not going to get better if he just gets an excuse. Just apologize and get better with it next time. I think in order for all fathers to be 100% responsible is, I believe that before you have children, I think it should be like some kind of test that you go through first to make sure that you're like ready for it. Because I don't think that a lot of people and a lot of parents know that they're getting into when they have kids, and not even good parents don't. But I'm saying, like, they should have an idea of what they're going to go through when they're having kids. And like, if you know that you can't do it, don't have kids. And I think that's something that a lot of fathers need to think about. I noticed something about myself. I have like, what do you call it? I don't have a lot of motivation, but when I'm reminded about something constantly, I become more motivated, and it helps keep me focused. And I think that when you have like a father to help you do that, and like somebody who's closer to you to help you keep on target, your life is a lot easier. My name is Menelik Hill Odom. I'm 13 years old in the 7th grade.
I became homeless when I was 17, going on 18. My adopted mother put me out end of my last year of high school, and I thought it was kind of fun. And I really didn't care at first because I was living with friends and all that type of stuff, but when reality really set in that, you know, I couldn't go back home, and, you know, I realized that I'm homeless. I don't have nowhere to live. So I just kind of floated around from place to place, and when that ran out, I didn't have no shelter, so like the streets just became my shelter. You know, I was walking around outside all night, and I was staying with people I didn't know. People would be picking me up, and I just had angels around me or something, because people wouldn't even know me. I would just like meet them, and they would like let me stay with them and stuff like that. And all the occasions weren't good occasions either. I could have really lost my life a lot of times like that. You know,
the thing that caused my homelessness was my anger problem. Me and my mom went through a lot of arguments and fight, and I just always wanted to run away from her house because I just wanted to be away from her. So when I ran away, I just started looking for love somewhere else because she wasn't giving to me at her house. So I started searching for boyfriends. Baby, being young, I didn't know no better. I just wanted somebody to love me and show me the love that she never gave me. So I fell in love with this grown man. He told me everything I wanted to hear. He made me feel like I was loved. Got pregnant by him. And when I got pregnant, she kicked me out. And ever since then, when she kicked me out, I never went back.
I know some of my barriers are being disabled and not really being able to work and make more money to provide for me and my children. So that's kind of my biggest obstacle. Basically, the reason for me being homeless is just, you know, I would have to say a combination of irresponsibility, you know, carelessness. Just, you know, people say you have to, every day you have to live your life like it's the last day. And no, that's not true. Once you get caught up thinking that all you have is today, sometimes you don't see tomorrow. It's when you end up in that's when new life is for that. So I've kind of learned that, you know, you have to take it one day at a time, and you also have to plan for today, but also for the future.
Bethel New Life Supportive Housing Program has been providing support to homeless families since 1988. It began with Westside Housing for Independent Living and expanded to the Family Wellness Center in 1995, a facility that is able to accommodate single and two-family adult households with children. Bethel Supportive Housing Program consists of interim and second-stage housing with supportive services that provide a safe and nurturing environment. In addition to the temporary housing sites, there are 16 units of scattered site permanent housing in the West Garfield area. Services include after-school programs for youth and children, case management, cultural arts and events, life skills training, parenting classes, and substance abuse referrals. Westside Housing for Independent Living consists of 27 single rooms for homeless women and children, shared kitchen and dining room, and large family room. Family Wellness Center consists of 24 one, two, and three bedroom spacious apartments, two parent families with children, or one parent, male or female, with children. If you would like more information, please call 773-921-3632.
Bethel New Life has helped me, I say, by providing a place for me and my kids to stay. Because it could be a lot worse than what it is. I see people sleeping in the park. I seen people sleep outside in their cars with their kids. So I say they helped me by giving me and my kids a warm place to stay and being able to talk to some of the staff people that work here. You know, and they give you some insight to some things that you don't know. You may have resources, but they might have some resources that you don't have. And, you know, more information is good information to me. So that's how I feel like Bethel helped me. And although at times it may seem challenging, I just kind of, you know, keep to myself and focus on what I have to focus on, take care of my business. But for me, that's pretty much how my situation came about. But now I know better, and I know what not to do. So it's like they say, when you know better, you'll do better. So I know better.
Will I lose my dignity? Will someone care?